Hey guys, hope you all are doing well. So guys, this is our first video on HTML. In this video, I'm gonna give you an introduction about HTML and some basic elements of HTML. So let's start our video. I hope you will enjoy the entire course. Actually, first of all, we have to discuss about it. What is HTML? Why do we use it? What is the use of HTML? So here I have written some points. As you can see here, let me make it bigger. As you can see here, it is written the full form of HTML. It is an hypertext markup language. Remember it, it's not a programming language, it's hypertext markup language, and it is used to make a structure of a website. You know, on internet, if you open a website, it has HTML. Without HTML, there isn't any website. So remember it, without HTML we cannot create, we cannot develop a website, and it is used to a structure of website. Same if I give you example of it, as we build buildings, first of all we make its structure like this. Whenever we create a website, so we need its structure. To make its structure, we use HTML. Fine, and there is no website with HTML. I have told this before. It's very easy to learn. So here, how you can start your HTML career, how you can start your HTML journey, you just need to download a code editor. Actually, you can also write your code in your Notepad, which is your default software in your desktop, Windows, whatever you have. Fine, but I suggest you personally download Visual Studio Code Editor. So how you can download Visual Studio Code Editor? You can simply go in your browser, whatever browser you have, you can go there, search on Google Visual Studio. Visual Studio is created by Microsoft. Here it is on my taskbar. I have pinned this particular software. Actually, why do we use this software? Because it makes our work easier. Like whenever we are writing some code, so it suggests us some code and write the code automatically. That's why it makes our work easier. Fine, so I have opened this software, Visual Studio Code Editor, and here we will be writing our complete code. So here you go. First of all, what you need, where you will keep your code, HTML code, you just need to here you can see I have created a folder. In this folder I'm gonna keep my entire website. Getting my point? Whatever pages I create, like if you go in a website, so you can find so many pages there, like about us page, contact page, home page, and so many pages, privacy page. So here we will be keeping our entire content here. Fine, so this is a folder I have created earlier, and I named it HTML. So go in your code editor and press the button Control N. Whenever you press Control N, it will create a page for us. Fine, and we will save this page. I will go in File. You can also use shortcut keys because it makes our work easier. It saves our time actually. So go into Control S. Here you can see save, shortcut key is there, Control S, and here, okay, fine. Select your particular folder. My folder is in desktop HTML. I selected. Now name your page. What I know, how you write the name, index.html. It is very necessary for you to write its extension .html, because now we are giving command to computer that this particular page is actually a HTML page. That's why you should write .html. And here I have written index. It's up to you, whatever you name it. You can name it about us, you can name it contact page, but the extension should be HTML. Remember this word. and save it. Okay, fine, we saved it. Now I'm gonna tell you that what will be its syntax. What is the syntax of HTML? Actually, first of all, you need to write this code HTML. This is element, fine. Open it and close it. How you close a HTML element giving a slash, fine, and use these arrows also. So write HTML, open HTML and close HTML. Inside these two elements we will be keeping our entire code, we will be writing our code, we will be giving a structure to our website, fine. So after HTML, as you know, as a human being, we have a body, we have a header section, we have a body, we have a footer section. Same thing will be in our website. So first of all, here will come our head. So head element, can you see that I just wrote head and it's giving me suggestion. This is why we use Visual Studio, because it makes our work easier. As you can see here, it has written the complete code. So I will just press enter and it will write all the code. So did you see that, the magic? Okay, fine. So in your header section, actually we will be keeping so many things here, but I will tell all the things in next episodes whenever you will have a good command on HTML, fine. So now under this head element, we will write our body element, fine. I will write body and enter. Now inside this body we will have our entire content. What content? I will show you an example here. So fine, I will write h1, enter. So it has written so many things, we don't need this actually right now. So I will erase this code and I will write manually h1 and I will close it, fine. Now inside this h1 we will write some code. Actually it's our head element, fine. Whenever you want to actually keep you want to write a heading, so you need h1. Actually it's not only h1, h1 is the biggest heading. I will show you an example here. So I will write here hello world, fine. This is our hello world, first hello world. So I will save this page. Remember, save this page. How you save it? Go into file, or you can also use the shortcut key control s. Now this page is saved. If you want to see your code in your browser, go inside your folder. Here is my folder, HTML folder. Now in this folder I have my page index. I will open it in my browser. Whatever browser you have, you can open it from there, but I use Chrome, so I will open it in Chrome. Okay, I will go in Google Chrome. Now wait and see what's happening here, how you actually make a structure of a website, how you handle a website. This is very basic, so you should get everything, fine. So I will provide you some elements. I will write some elements in PDF. I will provide you in description box. Remember, go in description and take that PDF, download it and have a look on everything. And remember, I will upload more videos on HTML, fine. I will upload more videos for you. We will cover this entire HTML course. So you should be consistent on the course. Don't watch all the videos in one day. Don't watch 5-6 videos in one day. Just watch one video in one day and practice that, because practice makes you perfect. If you don't practice, you cannot learn it, because programming, coding, it needs practice. Without practice, you cannot learn anything. So I hope you got it. So it's just opening because my PC is low. I have to actually put some RAM here. It's very slow. So let's see what happens there. Actually our page is loading here. Now here you see that our page is showing some content, hello world, because we gave here a command to our computer that show hello world in our page with heading, fine. Now I will show you another example of h2 element. You can see h2, actually h2 H2 is smaller than H1. There are six types of heading in HTML. We have H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. You can use whatever you have. I will copy this, my text, I will paste it here, and I will save this page with our short key Control S. Fine, it's saved here. Now go in your browser, refresh the page. As you can see, we got another hello world. It's smaller than the first one. Fine. So hey, it is how you write code in HTML. Now I will show you my paragraph element, how you write paragraph in HTML. It's very easy. Just write P. Now inside this P element, actually these are called element, you can also call them tag, HTML tag, HTML elements. And it's necessary to use a slash to close the element. You should use two elements, open element and close element. Fine. And here I will write something lorem. Just you can see it's giving me suggestion. I will select lorem. Now it has written so many things for me. Fine. That's why it makes it easier. I use Visual Studio and I suggest it to use Visual Studio. Now I will refresh them. As you can see, we have got so many content here, we have got so many text. But actually, what if I say I want to break the line from here? You can see this exclamation mark. I want to break the line from here. What will I do? I will go in my code and I will find that area. Oh, fine, it here it is. Now I will use an HTML element to break this line. What is that element? BR. And this element, you don't need to use a close element for this, because it does not need to close this. You just use BR tag and save this. The page is saved. Go here, refresh the page. As you can see, we use the BR tag after this exclamation mark, and it has broken the line, and our content is showing two lines. You can use it multiple times, whatever you want, how you want to show your content on your website. You can manage it yourself. So guys, I hope you love this video and you got whatever I said in this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will be uploading more videos on it, and I will try my best to make it more easier for you. I will give this page in description box. I will also provide you some notes in PDF. Download the PDF and write them and remember them and do practice, because practice makes you perfect. Fine. Hope you enjoyed the video. I will see you in next episode.